Today we will talk about the humor in translating talk shows. So these are the contents of the presentation. The first part is about the definition, and the second part is the translation of talk shows from English to Chinese and Chinese to English. And the third part is the comments and suggestions. So first, let me look at the definitions. Okay, next page. This is the definition of talk show. A talk show or chat show in British English is a television program of radio program genre structured around the act of spontaneous conversation. A talk show is distinguished from other television programs by certain common attributes in a talk show. One person or a group of person or guests discuss various topics put forth by a talk show host. This discussion can be in the form of an interview or a simple conversation about important social, political, or religious issues and events. The personality of the host shapes the tone of the show, which also defines the trademark of the show. A common feature or unwritten rule of talk shows is to be based on fresh talk. When it's talk that is spontaneous or has the appearance of spontaneity. Before doing this research, I have to say I have quite plain understanding about talk show, but I list the subgenres of the talk show like breakfast, chat, or early morning shows, and late morning chat shows, daytime tabloid talk shows, and so on. So there are many subgenres about talk shows, but before I do this, I just know something about like 脫口秀大會or the opera talk shows. Next page. And then this is the most important part of the presentation. So the definition of humor, the word humor originally derived from the humoral medicine of ancient Greeks, which taught that the balance of fluids in the human body, known as humourous, Latin humor, and controlled human health and emotion. Yōmō in Chinese can be traced back to the Warring States period in ancient China, meaning silence and quietness when it first appeared in the song of Chu as 孔敬幽默. Lin Yu Tang was believed as the earliest person to transliterate the English word humor to yōmō. And this is the definition of humor in the Longman Dictionary of Contemporary English. It says, the quality in something that make it funny and the ability to understand and enjoy amusing situations or to laugh at things. And scholars have defined humor from different aspects. And though the difference of their definition exists, share similarity. The common point of definitions can be conclude that the direct function and purpose of humor is to elicit laughter, and some means are needed to create humor. The understanding of definition of humor is helpful in dealing with difficulty of interpreting humorous utterance. It's undeniable that some humor can make some people laugh but may not make other people laugh, because humor involves many actors, and all of these are related to cognitive context, which is closely associated with the differences of cognitive subjects in terms of social and cultural background, immediate context, and encyclopedic knowledge, and so on. And that is the reason why we have difficulty in dealing with humorous utterance. Next we will talk about the Chinese to English translation of talk shows. It is pretty common to see talk show comedians who are not as impressive as their texts, but who are surprisingly popular with the audience when they perform on the stage. This is because most talk shows comedians have some experience of performing offline before they go on stage. And they, many of them close encounters with audiences have gradually honed the talk show comedian skills and techniques. So as the language of talk show is the more spontaneous and natural spoken humor of the stage, the strategy of making laughs necessarily involves the careful use of linguistic elements and comedic processing. So I will analyze the humor in Chinese talk shows through three ways. The first perspective is voice, by using pause, accents, homonym, and the second perspective is words, by using creative learning and buzzwords to make laughter. And the second one is rhetoric, use simile, repetition, parallelism, and so on. Actually, there are so many ways to make laughter in talk shows, but I just choose three of them. And this is from the first perspective voice, that using the pause, their narration, so that catching the punchline after the pause, that's adding to the humor of the comedy language. While the short pause in speech gives the communicator a certain psychological expectation, as the discontinuity of sound in the midst of information output reflects the meeting of new, old, and new information. And this is the script of this plot.
大家可以看到，其实如果只是看这一段文字的话，可能。感觉没有那么好笑，但是通过它一些停顿，然后会给大家一种就是期待吧，然后大家就可能会想要去猜一下他下一句会说什么，然后就最后出现这样一句啊，我晕过去了，就是一个反转，然后就成为了一个笑点。啊，下一个。
The next perspective is from the accents. Using these kind of emphasize, the talk show comedians will use this as a means of differentiation and emphasize the element of information that they want the audience to be received. And the next part is the homonym, which is called 谐音梗 in Chinese.
其实说到谐音梗，我自己有很就是。因为我也经常在网上冲浪嘛，然后就是谐音梗这个东西，其实大家对这个东西争议很大，有的人就觉得就谐音梗扣钱，但是有的人就很喜欢玩这种谐音梗，我不太清楚大家对于谐音梗的看法，然后这个是我找到了一个谐音梗的片段。这个片段对于谐音梗有没有什么看法？但其实我个人觉得很多谐音梗都挺冷的，就是这个笑点很容易让人 get 到，然后但我觉得这个选手他就是比较厉害的一点，就是他最后那一句我是真的不是很想晋级，好像把那个尴尬的局面挽回了一点点，然后就是next page。So the second perspective is to use words to emphasize the humor elements in their scripts. The first one is creative learning. That means you gave a new definition to or a new understanding to a word. For comedic effects, speakers sometimes deliberately misinterpret certain words, intentionally taking them out of their context, distorting their interpretation, and deviating from the audience's everyday perception in order to achieve a comedic effect. And this the script. 这一段就是他的梗，就是在于他提到了指南这个词，然后他后面又说了一句你用这个指南根本找不到北，所以就是用一种比较清奇的角度去赋予一个词新的含义然后这样来制造笑点。第二个就是use buzzword,
As you all surfing on the internet, I know that all of you know some buzzword on the internet recently. Can you give me some examples? The words that's pretty popular in the internet.
Oh, this
is crucial. Oh, this is crucial. 都展开了，还有吗？啊、从内到外都展开了。
你是我的神。
你是我的神。还有吗？大家还可以想到其他的吗？老师，您有了解过吗？
给老师解释一下吧。
这些梗就是刚刚提到的，你是我的神，还有那个都展开了，这些都是属于文艺复兴的梗，就是它是很多年前的那个视频，就是明星采访的视频，然后就是它也属于一种旧词新解吧，就是大家给它赋予了一些新的含义。然后就是这个梗它很万能，就是你好像你也给不出它一种特定的解释，但是你就用在任何地方都可以，比如说那个都展开了，由内到外都展开了，什么东西都可以展开。然后你是我的神这句话，就是你既可以当做一个嘲讽，也可以当做一句夸奖，所以这个就是利用一些 buzzwords。 然后这个是 script的角度，就是旧词新解，也不算新词新解吧，就是海王，它是指那种怎么说？
给老师解释一下。
可能同时和很多人保持比较亲密的关系。异性，对，也可以同性，对。广撒网，然后想要钓很多鱼的那种。然后他在这里面用到了这个词，其实脱口秀它之所以这么受欢迎，就是它能够给一些词不仅是赋予一些新的含义，另外一方面就是它需要跟上这个潮流，因为大多数的受众还是年轻人为主，所以在这里面这个词，这个海王，就是也算是旧新词新解。下一个就是from the perspective of rhetoric, this is quite common in the scripts of talk shows. The first one is simile. Simile is one of the most common and widely used forms of rhetoric in talk shows. The use of association and the use of concrete vivid things to replace abstract and difficult to understanding things. The use of simile can often achieve the experience and feeling of being here and hearing the sound. Speaker, 他把就是父母那一辈催婚的那种场景比喻成了这种就是好像在审讯一样的这个状态。但其实我个人对这个段子并不是非常的觉得好笑，我是觉得有一种感同身受的那种感觉，但笑点我觉得一般吧。And the next one is the repetition. Repetition is a rhetorical method in which words and or sentences are intentionally repeated according to the need of expression. The talk show speakers often use certain words and phrases deliberately in order to emphasize a certain level of meaning or highlight some information. 我看过很多历史，也读过很多兵法，但那一刻我还是上头了。就是他利用这种方式可以逐渐的把那个笑点越推越高，然后到最后就达到了一种就比较炸的那种舞台效果。And the last one is the parallelism. Well, parallelism is quite different with the repetition. They differ slightly. Firstly, the structure of
repetition is exactly the same, while the structure of parallelism can vary. And secondly, they differ in the number of words and phrases they form. Repetition is repeated twice, while the parallelism is repeated three times or even more. And the effect of repetition is different, as repetition is generally used to express strong emotions, while the parallelism is used to enhance momentum and expression. 也是刚刚看过的一个选手他的一个片段，就是我觉得这个段子我觉得还挺好笑的，就是它也是一个递进的关系，然后最后又回到了原点，所以我觉得还是挺妙的。接下来就是我在翻译就是脱口秀的时候遇到了一些比较有趣的句子。这一段就是他的原文是在感情方面也是你知道吗，就比如说有前任谈恋爱，他们肯定会怀疑他到底图我什么呢，我也一直有个疑惑，他和我谈恋爱到底是图我什么呢，图我的小黄车押金吗，可他早就黄了呀。这个黄就是在我们家那边的语言里面，他就指的是就不景气了，然后衰败的那个意思，跟前面的那个小黄车，大家也都知道这个事情，就是小黄车它那个破产了那公司。然后在中文里面，它就就是从小黄车那个黄，它可能是黄色的意思，但是后面他说可它早就黄了呀，那个黄就指的是它已经衰败了，不景气了，然后。就我个人觉得在翻译的时候就比较难用同样的一个词表达出不同的意思，所以在这里面我最后就只能是解释了一下这个后面那个黄它指的是It's beyond hope to apply for a refund since it went bankrupt。 等一下，就我想知道大家有没有什么比较好的建议或者想法，关于这种问题的翻译。
没有，就是没办法，翻不了就放不了。
对，就是我自己在翻译过程的，就翻译的过程当中，我也是觉得就是有很多的 gap， 有的时候会觉得比较遗憾，就是因为你在听中文的时候就觉得很好笑，但是你发过去的就是达不到那个笑点，就像这个一样，就到最后就只能是说明一下这个情况，可能大家都不会觉得，就是如果说是英语为母语的听众他们去听的话就 get 不到这个笑点。然后这个就是我刚刚讲的那个段子里面的一部分，到最后这个事儿我思来想去只有一种可能，他暗恋我，当时啊我一下子就想通了很多事情，怪不得呀，你说他为什么半夜三点还给我发微信想我，哼，男人还搁这诱敌深入欲擒故纵。这个是李雪琴她的那个段子里面的一部分，其实她是有东北口音的，所以你可以看到她就是有很多那种语气词，然后最后还说还隔着诱敌深入欲擒故纵。所以就是我觉得这种方言也是在这个翻译当中就是很难去达到的一种效果，所以最后我就是用了一个 playing hard to get， 算是找到一个相对来说有对应含义的一种表英文的一种表达，代替了这个诱敌深入欲擒故纵。但是像那种方言的语气就可能翻译不出来了。然后这个也是我到这儿来是我老板让我来的，他天天忽忽悠悠的给我画饼，你可以的，你很棒，有天赋，你能进决赛，完了你就飞黄腾达了。你说我有啥天赋呀，我就有个饼。画饼这个词现在也是 我觉得也算是一个 buzzword 吧。但这个词就其实很早就有了，它指的就是给人一种不切实际的幻想。就可能你去公司上班，然后你去公司应聘，然后那 HR 就跟你说啊，你一个月能挣50000块钱，然后每天就是不加班，就是那种，就是他可能给你画饼，然后这里面的画饼呢，其实就是这个，就是那个意思，但他最后说，我有啥天赋呀，我就有个饼，我在最开始的时候是把这个就是。画饼翻译成 the pie in the sky， 就是类似看起来是有这个东西，但是你又够不着，然后后面我又用了 potential 代替那个天赋，然后最后呢，他又提到了天赋，又换成了 potential， 然后最后又回到了这个饼，然后我又把它翻译成了 pie， 所以到最后是就是 potential 和 pie 属于一种alliteration 的一个感觉吧。然后这个就是我在处理这个的时候的一个反应策略，然后我不知道大家有什么比较好的想法或者建议，但就我自己在翻的时候感觉还是真的挺困难的，就是因为这个东西它本身就是给人带来快乐的一种东西，但是你如果解释的太多了的话，就可能效果并不会很好。然后接下来是我的 partner， 他会讲一下英文到中文的翻译。好多张 PPT 啊，
这个也是一个梗，就是周迅的那个好多人啊。就是 when I'm doing the English to Chinese translation， I think the main point is the It's the reference and cultural background. I think the reference is 梗，就是刚才提到那个，就是很多时候我们 get 不到某一个视频或者是其他的笑点，可能是因为就是我们不了解他说的这句话后面的一些含义或者是一些经历，比如说像之前就刚才说的那个，这是可以说的吗？或者是由内而外的展开，还有之前在豆瓣特别火的一句话，就是我老公是公务员，大家。还有那个啊，我是亲，就可能如果不玩豆瓣的可能是不清楚，但是呢像就是一些豆瓣资深用户就是会经常会用这一句啊，我是亲，或者是我老公是公务员。然后就是 culture I think is which encompasses all knowledge, beliefs, art, laws, cause is a complex of talents and habits that are mastered and accepted by members of society。就私情告啊，老师用它做一下封面。I think humor uses some cultural elements which only people who have grown up in this culture, people who come from a different culture with broad knowledge of this specific culture can understand. And I think when we translate culture related humor, we must suppose that the target audience do not know the cultural elements that was employed in speech which is difficult. 就像我刚才说，如果你想翻译一些豆瓣网页给外国人看，可能那个人就用了我刚才说那个，就说啊，我是亲，就这个梗其实就是因为就是有一个人在生活组发帖，就说他就问别人有没有遇到一个婉婉类亲的情况，意思就是说他有没有被别人当成替身，就别，然后呢底下有一个评论就是属于凡尔赛吧，就是说有啊，然后说就说，然后他巴拉巴拉述讲述完自己经历之后说了一句啊，我是亲，就他意思就是说他才是被模仿的那个，就是然后一时之间就广为流传在豆瓣那个 APP。I think as for humor translation, it lays more stress on the same response to the humor between the original audience and the target one. Since Westerners and the Chinese have a different understanding toward humor, in order to offer a functionally equivalent translation, I think the functional equivalence indicates that it's useful, and which indicates that translators can make some proper adaption strategies if there are, if there are differences between the original source text and the target language. First, I want to introduce the strategies which I used when I preparing this presentation. It's the addition. 就是增益法。Next, I will show an example. It's short.这个就是刚才那个文本，就是他这个背景其实是当时是有一个黑人被白人警察意外被他压迫，然后就死掉了，就是在街上，然后他走在街上，然后就被射杀。他就是想借这个梗，就是当时是新冠，大家都在隔离，他就是说，就我们可以看到他这个，他就是说西班牙的民众都在隔离，然后警察就在街上为了算是一种奖励，说大家都好好在居家隔离，所以他们就在街上为那些民众唱歌。他说这种事情是不可能发生在美国的，因为他说如果有人黑人就是在唱歌的时候给他们鼓掌，他们可能警察就会开枪。然后这个其实就在讽刺说美国的那个种族矛盾其实很深的。所以我觉得如果在翻译的时候我们是可以加一句，就是说解释给一些观众，给一些中国观众解释一下，说他为什么要这样子说，是因为他们就是当时在美国当时的种族矛盾是存在种族矛盾的。所以我自己翻的时候我是加了一个，毕竟美国的黑人种族歧视问题已经由来已久了。就是这个是来自那个小崔句宅家每日秀，我自己也有在 B 站就是翻译过，所以我当时是这样子翻的。然后 next is the domestication. I think domestication is a very useful strategy when translating the source text and translating from the different language cultures, which may next is another example.